Our top story. 4 days after a hit and run in Mumbai's Worli shook the entire country, the cry for justice is only growing louder. The prime accused in the case, Mihir Shah, the son of Shiv Sena leader Rajesh Shah, was arrested yesterday after being on the run for nearly 60 hours. He has now been sent to police custody till July 16th. But how could the main accused in such a high-profile case remain absconding for 3 days, especially in a city like Mumbai? Well, we have our answers now. The investigation has revealed that Mihir attempted to conceal his identity by shaving his beard off after committing the crime so that no one would recognize him. He also exchanged multiple calls with his father, who asked him to leave Mumbai and assured him that the driver will take the blame for the incident, for the murder. Mihir Shah has now confessed to the cops that he indeed was driving the BMW, which hit a scooter-borne couple before dragging Kaveri, the wife, for a kilometer and a half and then running over her not once but twice. The cops also claim they have enough evidence to prove that Mihir did consume alcohol when he went out with his friends to a pub in Juhu the night before the hit and run. Meanwhile, illegal parts of the pub which Mihir visited have now been demolished after its license was revoked by the state government. The victim's family, that is Kaveri's family, is very clear with its demand. They say Mihir Shah must be booked for murder.
आज जो है कोर्ट में 16 तारीख तक पुलिस कस्टडी एक्सटेंड की गई है मिहिर शाह की.
क्या कहना चाहेंगे, क्या डिमांड है आपकी?
उसको फास्ट ट्रैक में जल्द से जल्द सजा होनी मिलता है. उसको फांसी नहीं तो हमारे गाड़ी के सामने उसको ला के उसको वैसे ही घिसीट के लेके जाऊंगा मैं, जैसे मेरे वाइफ को घिसीट के लेके आओ. ऐसा कृत्य करना, एक बार ऐसा उसके साथ हो गया ना तो सबको पता चलेगा कि दुनिया में क्राइम करना सब लोग भूल जाएंगे. आज मेरे वाइफ के साथ हुआ है ना, वैसा किसी के साथ ना हो. आज जो हुआ है वो सब दुनिया देख रही है, फिर भी सब चुप रही है. एक ही है कि उसको फांसी या मेरे गाड़ी के सामने लाके उसको मैं कुचला दूंगा. मेरी यही मांग है सरकार से कि फास्ट ट्रैक में जल्द से जल्द उसको सजा हो जाए. बस मेरे को न्याय मांगता है, न्याय के अलावा मैं कुछ नहीं जानता.
10 लाख रुपए अनाउंस किए सीएम ने, क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
मेरे को 10 लाख नहीं मांगता है, मेरे को 1 करोड़ रुपया देगा, 10 करोड़ रुपया देगा, फिर भी मेरे को नहीं मांगता है. मेरे को न्याय मांगता है, मेरे वाइफ को न्याय मांगता है, मेरे को कुछ नहीं मांगता है. पैसा वीसा, पैसा तुमको रखो, मेरे को न्याय दे दो.
Facing flak from both the public and political opponents, the Shiv Sena has finally taken action against Mihir's father, Rajesh Shah. He's been removed from his position by the ruling party. He's not been suspended, merely removed from his position. In fact, Chief Minister Shinde has reiterated that no matter who the accused is, the government will act without bias. However, the opposition is gunning for the Mahayuti government. They are claiming for 3 days, Mihir was saved so that alcohol could not be traced from his body. Opposition parties are also demanding that the VVIP brat be booked for murder.
Opposition hamesha aarop karte rehti hai. Unke paas aarop ke siwa dusra koi kaam hai? Hum log constructive kaam kar rahe hain. हम प्रैक्टिकल काम कर रहे हैं और लोगों के बीच में देख रहे हैं हमारे कितने प्रोजेक्ट शुरू है. हिट एंड रन में मैंने पहले दिन से इंस्ट्रक्शन दिए हुए हैं, कोई भी हो कानून के सामने सब बराबर है, कोई बड़ा छोटा नहीं होता. और हिट एंड रन में जो दोषी है, जो गुनाहगार है, उनको बिल्कुल बख्शा नहीं जाएगा. जो बार है, जो देर रात तक चलते हैं, पब है, उनके ऊपर भी कड़ी कार्रवाई करने का आदेश मैंने दिया हुआ है. पार्टी से निकालना, इससे जो गुनाहगार है उसके ऊपर कार्रवाई करना, इसको प्राथमिकता देनी चाहिए. और जो विक्टिम है उनके उनको सपोर्ट करना, ये पहली बात है. उनके परिवार को मुख्यमंत्री सहायता निधि से 10 लाख रुपए देंगे.
Mihir Shah, who is the son of Rajesh Shah, now he was hiding in Thane. Thane is a stronghold of Shinde Sarkar. What do you want to tell about
this? I said this, that this should be treated as a murder case, and I hope that these charges will be put for murder and there will be bulldozer justice as they do for other people.
So do you think that this was an entire cover-up as he was caught after 60 hours?
It seems like it now. First, I said I will not politicize this case, but it seems like it.
Okay, it seems that there are other states that are learning a lesson from Maharashtra, where there's not just been this BMW case, there has also been the Pune Porsche case. So this is what happened in Uttar Pradesh. The Noida police has now issued a stern warning to all parents. It has said that parents will be penalized if minors are caught driving. Authorities have also said that a fine of 25,000 rupees and a year-long cancellation of vehicle registration will also be slapped on defaulters. In fact, flouting of rules will also debar the minor from availing a license till the age of 25. Many of these provisions, of course, are already in the Motor Vehicles Act. Vikram Singh is an ex-DGP of Uttar Pradesh. He's joining us on the broadcast. Vikram Singh, thank you very much for being with us here. My only question to you is, the fact is, in the law, it is very clear if you find minors driving, it is parents who will be penalized. It is their licenses that will be cancelled. The Uttar Pradesh police, in fact, the Noida police, where you and I live, is reiterating it. My point is, will it have any impact? Because these motor vehicle rules have been in place since 2019. And yet we have seen a spate of hit and runs involving minors. In fact, one data is telling us that almost 40% of fatalities in hit and runs is at the hands of minors.
Very true, Shreya. A law is only as good as it is its faithful implementation. Faithful implementation, it becomes a game changer. Lax implementation, well, there is no use of having a law that is not implemented at all. But I strongly commend the role of the Noida police that they have reaffirmed and reiterated these provisions of law. And of course, I'm sure they would be able to implement it also. Apart from rash and negligent driving, you also have stunt driving. Especially on weekends, you have youngsters and killer brats driving their super bikes and super cars as in a dangerous mode. That also needs to be checked. Reinforce the CCTV network. And also, those who were earlier offenders, they need also to be kept under surveillance so that they do not repeat the offense that they were booked earlier. But I would strongly, certainly like to compliment Lakshmi Singh, the police commissioner of Noida, the Noida police, for coming out and reiterating those provisions of law which are required today so that we do not have a Pune case or a Mumbai case in Noida here now.
Vikram Singh, before I let you go, 20 seconds. When I look at what has happened in Maharashtra, whether it is in Pune, whether it is in Mumbai, I think to myself, is there no fear of the law in this country? If you're rich and if you're powerful and if you're politically connected, do you think you can get away with anything?
Unfortunately, I wish I could contradict you. But what happened in Pune and Mumbai gives the indication, the sense of entitlement of the killer blacks. Both belong to builder fathers. Both have political networks. One has network connection with the underworld. And yes, they bought their way out. They substituted the blood samples. They could manage to get pizza so as to remove the alcohol content from the stomach. And in this case, it is even worse. It's a cold-blooded deliberate murder. I'm very disappointed. I would have been very happy if cold-blooded deliberate murder sections were invoked, because the manner in which they reversed the car and mutilated,
correct,
it's not the dead body. It's the question of the person. I would say the survivor. They did not know whether the woman was alive or dead. But and therefore, I would say the mens rea was there, cold-blooded deliberate murder, and also invoke the provisions of the National Security Act. Nothing like this, sir. Only sanctimonious platitudes. Vachanam Kim, that is the only talk big and deliver nothing.
Absolutely. I agree with you 100%, Vikram Singh. Thank you very much for joining us. This is cold-blooded murder. This is not just a hit and run. This is also a case, as far as Mumbai is concerned, this is also a case where the driver reverses the car and then runs over the woman twice without knowing whether she's dead or alive. What is the decent thing to do, ladies and gentlemen? If I, by mistake, hit someone, that person falls, I'm supposed to pick them up in my car and take them to the hospital. Look at what this brat does. Look at what this driver does. He thinks he's above the law, so he can do anything. He can switch sides with the driver. The driver can then reverse and crush this woman, run over her twice to ensure she's dead and that the crime can be hidden. But as I said, crimes like these can never be hidden.